Okay, I'm Suresh. I run a company called TELiBrahma, focusing on mobile advertising space. I think till last year, okay, so till around 2011 August, okay, and probably this one, right, even before Intel came in, I was of the firm opinion that we should be between 50-60. That's what we wanted to do. So we realized that the business that we are doing has too many pieces, okay, and there are two different pieces in the business that we operate. More and more we started working with the customer, more and more we started looking into the overall market. We realized that we are running a lot more in businesses, but two very, very clearly, two complex businesses we could very clearly see. So we decided that, okay, at some point of time, we need to have two different strategies for two parts of the business, A. And B, we realized that the pace at which we are growing, okay, and we had to build a lot of support structure around it. Unfortunately, the business that I am into, there is no ecosystem which is already built. Okay, so in fact, one of the challenges that we always had was globally we don't have competition for one part of the business. There is absolutely no competition. No one is trying to, makes the same mistake that we have done, okay, in terms of starting a business like what we have done, but good and bad, okay, so, and the second part of the business, which is around augmented reality, even there I can count the competition globally at the level in which we are in, right, so, if you look into mobile creatives, okay, and if you think into the thought process of, on mobile, etc., we think there is serious lack of resources in the country, so we have to build it from scratch. That's where we ended up becoming 130, 135 because there was no one whom we can depend on in the industry to do that for us. Probably I was lucky to have the first 60 people right. Right, they made sure that next 60 people almost become comfortable. Okay, so this, that's one thing. Second one, as an organization, we had to take a lot of stuff. Okay, so what you said is right. Right, so you struggle hard to grow from a startup, and then you struggle a lot more to make sure that you are still a startup. That's what makes you feel energetic. That's one of the reason I said we created two divisions, etc. And then we took some very, very interesting initiatives, okay, and whether it in terms of internalizing something like hackathon, or whether it's in terms of celebrating the success, in terms of making teams to talk to each other better, right, empowering a lot more, etc. I think we did some very, very smart things to keep up that energy, right? And a lot of the people whom we hired were young guys, okay? So, and the instruction to them is come over and enjoy, okay? So, this is your direction, but you are free to do whatever it is. So, from that perspective, we are able to retain a lot of energy, startup energy. And the flip side of it is we continue to have the challenges of a startup in terms of whoever joins, he will have, he's challenged a lot more in terms of the risk that he will see, the confusion that he sees, etc. But I think we are able to bridge that pretty reasonably well. He's put it in a very, very nice way. He said the culture of, one of the great thinker, okay, and he joined us from a lot of MNCs, okay. So he came and told me that, Suresh, after one and a half months, he was talking about it to a lot of employees. Then he came and told me, Suresh, shall I tell you one thing? The culture of TELiBrahma is there is no culture. Okay, so that's our culture. Okay, so it's free, it's open, and whoever comes here, he can define his culture. We still have a opportunity by which someone can come in and impose whatever he feels as right on the organization, is what we feel. But otherwise, some of the stuff that I pass it on to the employees is there is what defines us is our colleagues. Okay, the only reason why you need to work in TELiBrahma is your colleagues will see you with a lot of respect. As long as you are able to get the respect of your colleagues in terms of doing what is required for the organization, right? So you will be happy in the organization. A. And B, I think as an organization we are able to retain humility. Right, so continue to learn and continue to be simple, continue to be, humble enough to absorb any thoughts. Okay, these are the two things that I think will define us. Uh, Right. I think first thing is they need to be persistent. They need to be persistence without being adamant. Okay. They need to be persistent. They need to be flexible in terms of learning what is required to be done. Okay. Is the persistence, but flexible and agile is the first point that I want to tell. Second one, I again say that, okay, I mean, get your product right. Okay, focus lot more on product. Okay, I mean, lot of people out there who say that sales is important, marketing is important. I agree with all those stuff are important, but have a overall view of your product. Sure. You can't have a bad product and sell it outstandingly. That will come back, hit you back. Yeah. So focus lot more on products is what I would advise them nowadays. And I think the third one is you don't have anything to lose, okay, and just be experimentative and always believe that the data from the market can surprise you compared to the gut view that you have, right? So listen to the market, look at lot of data points and take the call, and continuously experiment. Don't get too analytical, it's not going to work out here.
Right.
It's absolutely other way around. I'm asking them to work hard when I'm saying, let's get it right. Yeah, I'm trying to make them understand that working is fun, right? So it's easy for someone to go and say that, okay, I mean, work for 5 days a week, and you know, that's impossible. Yeah, they can't build a company, okay, and with that spirit, okay, and with the competition, with the market, with the challenges that we have, with the kind of quality that we have, it's impossible to build a company working for 5 days and 8 hours, okay, and it's easy to say that, okay, and I feel, as long as I'm not not inhuman, I'll ask them to work, okay, so my only suggestion is this, be here only if you enjoy your work, right, A, and do what you enjoy, right, so that's the only thing that I have, so, I mean, if you think you need to get away from the work to have fun, okay, then there is fundamentally wrong in terms of what you are doing or what environment we have created. We'll make sure that we will not make you feel bored about coming to the office, but you should enjoy your work, okay, and you can take off your health, all those things we understand, we don't even ask you what you want to do or what you this one, but the fun is in work, that's what we are trying to tell, okay, so, and not many times you get an opportunity wherein you create something from India and take it to the global market. And not many times you think you are not replicating what has happened in US, but you are trying to create a concept in India and trying to go to the world and say that this is how we should do it, what you are doing is wrong. Not many times you will get that opportunity, right? So I don't think what else can give you more kick than that. Okay, that's how we take it. No, I don't think investors change my company in any way, right? In fact, investors don't change the company, investors don't change the entrepreneur, right? So investors can bring in some discipline, right? Investors can work as a sounding board, right? So at least in our case, I don't think investors try to change anything, okay? So in fact, they say we should not change anything, okay?
Sure.
I can't say ultimate vision for TELiBrahma. I can tell you what is the ultimate vision for what we are doing. Okay, so that can take different. Okay, and whether TELiBrahma will be a public limited company, whether TELiBrahma will be part of some other company, whether TELiBrahma will be independently, I don't know. So I don't say TELiBrahma. Okay, in terms of what we are doing, we are passionate about what we are doing in terms of integrating the offline world with the digital experiences. Okay, so and we think anything which is static, anything in the real world there should be a way to integrate or engage with that, and that's what we continue to do. Okay, so and we believe any media in the world will be integrated with our technology, and we have an opportunity. That's what we want to do.
Sure.